Welcome viewers to Bruism TV. Bruism TV is a media platform where we build capacity for young people, for families, for people, entrepreneurs, leaders, people who are interested in national development. We are in a country that needs capacity, we are in a country that needs passion, patriotism, so that we can move our nation forward. And that's what is calling, we are a different part of different countries of Africa, different parts of the world. So today, I want to handle a topic briefly on what I call the power of vision. The power of vision. What is vision? Vision is your mental picture about your tomorrow. Again, vision is the plan of God for your life. Do you think that God created you for a purpose? The late Miles Monroe said, when purpose is not known, abuse is inevitable. Do you believe that you were created for a purpose? God did not just create you to be ordinary. There is a purpose, there was something in the mind of God before He created you. So through Bruism TV, we want to help you to actually discover this purpose, why God created you. So purpose is about the mind of the manufacturer before production. Are you aware that God is a producer, that you were produced for a purpose? For instance, Daniel was produced from the church to become an interpreter of her sentences in governance. So Daniel, in the Bible, that personality reminds us or describes somebody who is from the church and is sent, produced by the church, sent to society to interpret her sentence. And that's what I'm doing today in government. I don't actually see myself as a politician. I see myself as a political leader, as a Daniel, who is in government to interpret dreams. So why did God bring me into government? What is the purpose of God for bringing Bruism, for instance, this program? Why this program? There was something in the mind of the producer before he came. So what was in the mind of God before your creation, before creating you, that is purpose, that is vision. You need to understand the mind, the reason God created you. And then you break these things into, you know, from A to B to C, and then you have vision A, vision B, vision C, vision D, and then you move on. But I want to say this. If you want to know your vision, if you want to discover, create a mental picture, the plan of God, know about the plan of God for yourself, the first thing you need to do is to know the mind of God, your creator. Why is, am I going into politics? Am I going into entertainment? Am I going into the health system? Am I going into the business sphere? Am I going into entertainment? Which area do I have passion for? So I'm actually going to talk about the power of vision that is expressed through passion. So number one way to actually develop vision is to monitor what you have passion for. So I want you to know that passion is stronger than certificates. Passion is stronger than family background. Passion is stronger than what you have or what you do not have. All you need to do is to look deep to know what moves you like fire. If you read the Bible, says that it talks about what moves you like the wind. Something that moves you like the wind. When Paul saw Timothy in the scriptures, Paul said to Timothy, steer the gift of God which is already in you. So through Bruism platform, we are helping young people in Enugu State, helping young people in different parts of the Eastern Nigeria, helping young Nigerians, and even women. We are also talking to women. As a woman, why did God create you? Why are you a woman? What is the purpose? What is the mind of God for making you a woman? What are you supposed to do? What are the projects that you have to be behind the scene? And if you are not there, it will not work. So you have to understand where your passion is, because passion is one of the strongest ways of expressing your vision. What God wants you to achieve, okay? So vision is stronger than certificate. Don't allow certificate to stop you. Emeka Asogwa, my parents are poor. I don't have anybody to help me. Don't worry. Parental background cannot stop you. Number one way to discover vision is to follow your passion. What you love doing. Something that, okay, let me tell you about passion. What can you do without somebody paying you and you're happy doing it? That is where your future is. What is that thing that you are so excited about? Like me, I love youth empowerment. I love capacity building. I don't like to see somebody in one level for too long. I want somebody to move from where you are to the next level. And you, I love so much youth empowerment. My life, through what I'm doing by the grace of God today, about 33 Nigerian youth have been sent abroad. You know, I didn't use my money. Because one thing about passion is that when passion is stirred up, Are you with me? That's what we call angel investors. The supernatural investors, the angel investors will start backing what you are doing up. Young man listening to me right now, watching this program, are you passionate about something? Let me show you areas, spheres of society where you can actually monitor if you have passion. I've mentioned some of them. Entertainment. You see, Akin and Popo, they are short, but they are making millions. But you are short, you are crying. Why can't you, you know, convert your shortness into assignments? You are a young man listening to me right now. You have big head. You are anointed. You are fearfully made. Some people, the Bible says, you are fearfully and wonderfully made. So if your head is too big, you are fearfully made for a purpose. Convert the size of your head into assignment. You can even start a company and name it Big Head International Limited, just to make sure that you carry the size of your head to become an assignment. So what are you passionate about? Why did God create you that way? You are going far. You are loaded. There is something about you. Entertainment. Look at all these comedians. They make you laugh and you forget your problems. You go home and you face them again. But the thing is that they are making money because they are passionate. Clean the drunk or what? The guy was just what he does. I am sure when he was in primary school, he was passionate about comedy, secondary school, university, and today it is paying him. Passion may take time, but when it starts paying you, it pays you huge. There is sustainability when your passion starts paying you. Okay? I talked about entertainment. The second part, the society, where you can check if you have passion for, could be politics. Yes. When they say politics is dirty game, excuse me, is there any society, any part of society where there is no debt? Even your life, even you have your weaknesses, even your family, your brother could do one thing or the other. You have weaknesses and strengths. Excuse me, we need people who go into politics to make change. Daniels, my state, Enugu State, my governor is like a priest. My governor is like a priest. In fact, somebody told me the other day, if you want to see a governor, my governor, get him where he fellowships, because he must go to that fellowship. Every Sunday, he will go to church and also have his own fellowship in government house where government stakeholders come to worship God. Every Sunday. Excuse me, I want to beg you. Everything is not about wrong or what. You can make a choice to become different in politics. We are having more political leaders today than politicians. More political leaders are emerging. So you have to check yourself to know where your passion is so that you can help to interpret your sentences in government. Let me tell you, if you leave politics, governance for wrong people, we can never leave a good generation, we can never leave a good system, good society for our children and for our children's children. So we're going to do everything possible to make sure that the right people are in power. When the righteous are there, people will rejoice. You got that? Okay. So we want to do everything possible so that, let me tell you, you cannot be part of governance except you pass through politics. So most people say, I don't want to do politics, but you want good governance. It cannot work. You know why? You need politics to have access to governance. Good governance is not possible without politics. But politics is like the process that will bring good governance. So I want everyone to begin to look at yourself. Where are you passionate about politics? Are you passionate about leadership? Are you passionate about national development? You may be good in those, in that area, the area I call political sphere. Number three, I want to talk about another area of passion, business. Business, if you come to a stadium at Enugu Youth Development Center here at the Nnamdi Azikiwe Stadium, you will see what we are doing. We are encouraging young ones to stop depending on certificate, to stop depending on salary. Salary is never enough. Somebody defines salary as a bribe somebody gives to you to forget your dream. But if you are being paid because of what you have passion for, that is when you know you have a future. But if you are doing something just because of money, how can you buy a future through that? Passion is stronger than certificates. Yes, passion. Get into business. Get into skill development. Become an entrepreneur. Get entrepreneurial spirit. Become self-reliance. I became a millionaire in my 20s because I developed my talent, my gift. You can become a young man who is self-reliant because you understand the principles of entrepreneurship. We are raising entrepreneurs. We are raising people who will not become job seekers, but become entrepreneurs so that we can move Enugu State forward. We can move Nigeria forward. Come down to Enugu and see what we are doing. We are taking young people to the farm. Burizen farms in Asoka, in Ezagu, in Kano West. In fact, the maize I'm eating in my house right now, I produced it through Burizen farms. And I told them to be the one they gave to me, I think I will eat it for almost 1 year. And I'm happy I'm eating what I'm producing. Young people must go back to business. If you go to business, you see different areas. But I always tell my brothers in the Eastern Nigeria that an average Igbo man sees business as shop, trading. But a Yoruba man sees business as economy, participating in economy, services. Remember, money is still defined, the way economy is defined, money, as medium of exchange for goods and services rendered. I want to beg you, don't see business as just, buying and selling. Business has gone beyond buying and selling. Communication is big business. Entertainment is big business. You must understand which area of business you have passion for and go for it. And I tell you, you are going to make impact. There is a difference between trading and business. Trading involves you, but business can be a system. And I want to encourage all Igbo boys, all the young people from Eastern Nigeria, we are very hardworking. But the problem is that we find it difficult to move our businesses from just buying and selling to a system. So you must develop that passion and also go for training, because passion is not enough. Remember, when we say passion, we're talking about talent. A great man wrote a book and he said, talent is never enough. Talent is never enough. An Igbo man must learn how to move business from buying and selling to system, to organizational growth. I want to encourage you. Maybe there is something you are passionate about. You want to go to a business fair, economy, you want to be in charge of the economy. Please start small. My friend Abaki, his name is Small Small. There is a principle of business that is called start small. Think big but start small. You can actually think big and start small. It's a principle of success, and it can make anything happen in your business. Business is a big sphere. What of a health sphere? Health. So many young people have been ravaged, by what they call HIV. You can be a platform. You can start a platform. You can be an agent of change. Where young people in secondary schools begin to learn how to overcome HIV, how to avoid HIV, how to avoid certain diseases, how to take care of their health, their menstrual system. You can even become a social entrepreneur. A social entrepreneur. Remember, a social entrepreneur is somebody who measures success by the level of impact created by him. So a business entrepreneur measures success by profits, but a social entrepreneur measures success by what? By impact. What have you achieved? What have you achieved over the years? Okay, it gives me joy when I see the number of young people that have traveled abroad because of what we are doing. It gives me joy. And I want to encourage you. You can see them excited at the airport. The young man, the first set in 2009, that through our youth programs, went abroad to China to study. I saw them at the airport. They were so excited. They were so blessed. And then we're making everything work for them. And I want to encourage you, please. Check and discover which area of society can you make impact. One of the ways to discover that is to follow your passion. Follow what you are passionate about. What is passion again? Passion is your strong love for something. Your strong love for something. What do you love so strongly that you can even do it without anybody paying you and you are happy doing it? That is where your future is. I want you to take out time. Monitor yourself. Check what you are passionate about. And that's how to get to the top. I always tell people, stop jumping up, start growing up. When you jump up, you jump down. When you grow up, you stay up. That is what passion can do for you. Passion may not pay you immediately, but when passion starts paying you, it pays for life. It pays for life. So I want to encourage you, do everything possible to understand your passion. Remember, Burism TV is here to help you so that you can grow, you can develop, we can discover the 3 Ds of Burism: discovery, development, and deployment. When we discover you, we develop you and we deploy you. Please check the contacts of Burism on screen right now, and then communicate us and give us feedback about how Burism program is affecting your life. I remember your brother Emeka Asogwa, SA to the Enugu State Governor on Youth Affairs. God bless you.